I think creativity is important in research. Being able to think of an idea or think of a possible molecule or potential group that you want to attach to a molecule. Either you're following what someone else has done or you come up maybe with your own ideas. And so being able to be creative, I think is a very big asset to being a researcher and maybe a chemist. Our research program focuses on the development of new materials like organic semiconductors and their implementation into prototype devices. Organic electronics are electronic devices that are based off of semiconductors, where those semiconductors are carbon-based and not sort of silicon-based, which is your traditional electronic device. So you could have something like a photovoltaic or a solar cell where the semiconductor is plastic and that'll absorb the light and convert it to electricity. When you have like a disaster relief, for example, you could have tents that have solar panels on them where the canvas is actually a photovoltaic woven into the canvas. These semiconductors can be made as like an ink, right? And so in this case, it was printed on a piece of plastic. And so the advantage to this is that you can print them using conventional printing processes.
Canada has been a pulp and paper in the printing industries for quite some time. The idea now is that as printed media changes, we're trying to put intelligence onto these flexible substrates. So you can imagine one day that you will be able to print your TV on a flexible substrate and roll it up and bring under your arm and then display it to some individuals.
So I think there are different strategies to designing materials, like pigments and dyes. Things that have bright colors can often be used as semiconductors as well. If we have these molecules, we want charge to jump from one molecule to the other. And so what we're looking for is molecules that'll stack very closely so that those charges can jump. So we might just do some fine tuning on a well-known dye pigment, which will convert it and then convert it into a semiconductor, which is actually has good properties in a device. Organic electronics can be fabricated several different ways. This one would be fabricated through vapor deposition. So you heat the molecule, it sublimes, and then it condenses, and you can make thin films. So there's no light bulb, where the light bulb is the semiconductor. It's a piece of plastic or a piece of carbon-based material. And so now we can actually take those molecules that we design in the lab and that we synthesize, and then we can sublime them and make devices with controlled thin layers.
Being a research-intensive university, the University of Ottawa really depends a lot on its interactions with industry. So with Dr. Lessard's work, there's essential industrial partners that are working along with us in moving his work forward. If we're developing these types of inventions here on our campus and working with Canadian industry as much as possible, then the hope is that this will be commercialized in Canada and that will lead to lots of jobs and all sorts of other offshooting benefits for the economy.
I see the future of this technology really integrating into our day-to-day life, you know. I would imagine we'll have buildings where they're covered in photovoltaics as, you know, to reduce the light but also to increase the power. The medical field is a big one too. If you can have sensors that are printed or flexible and built into your clothing, you know, they can detect things like, you know, your pH or your salt levels. And I mean, if you can take it a step further and start detecting maybe some of these markers for certain diseases, then you could have your clothes tell you when it's time to go see a doctor, right?